Okay, today's project, new charge pipe. This is what I'm slamming on there. Nice little charge pipe. They sent me all the hardware and everything with it, but this is the stock charge pipe right here. It's that big piece down there. Let's pop this off real quick. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You pop the cover off, move that out the way. That's the stock charge pipe right here. This, and it goes all the way down in there. So I got to take off my air box and everything else, get the discharge pipe, pull this thing off, put the new one on there, and let's see if we can do this. And like I said, you're just going to be taking off adapters. Like, you'll take this off. That's going to go on the charge pipe. You'll take the mass airflow sensor off. That'll come off. Like I said, these are all intake sensors right there, air intake, temp sensors, things like that. So one of the first things we're going to have to do is take off this air box. Like I said, I'm going to pop this little snip out here. You just snap that up, pull this back or whatever, and then that'll come off. Take off this big piece here so I can get my hand down in there and just start working on it. Like I said, I got to figure out exactly how to get down there without taking off too much, because I hate taking off things that you don't have to take off. Because if you end up breaking something, guess what? You got to put it back together. Okay, while I got the stuff apart, I went ahead and I got a K&N filter, so I just went and sprayed that out, got that sitting there. But getting this charge pipe out is going to be a lot easier than I thought. Now, once you get that air filter out, you got this whole side open right here. So, and like I said, this little grommet right here is actually on the back of that. I left it on the back side of that. It's going to just snap back down in there. It looks just like one of these. So it's going to just snap back down in there. But as you can see down at the charge pipe, let me see if I can get all the way down there. There we go. That's the charge pipe right there. So what you're going to do is you're going to pop that piece off right there. That's just like a little pull tab. You just pull it out towards you. The charge pipe slides towards the front of the car. So as soon as you pop that little tab out, I'm going to show you how it's going to look when you pop it out. Hold up. See, that's it right there. This little piece right here. It's this little silver piece or whatever, gold piece. This just pops straight up and out like this. Because it's got two sides to it. There's one on the other side, and it looks just like that. So you slide it up, you pop it towards you. Well, that's going to come off all the way. It's cool because I'm going to put it back on anyways. So I'm going to put it on my other charge pipe. So that pops off there. And then once you get that piece off, up here, you got the three bolts. There, there, and one up under there. Take these two pieces off, and that should get your charge pipe off. I mean, it's not that complicated. That's basically all it is. And so once you get those off, it should come off, and then you can start working on your other one over here, putting it back on. So let's see what we can do. Now, to get those three bolts off right there, that one, and that one, you're going to need a Torx bit. And this is a T27. That's what that is. Let me see. Yep, T27 Torx bit is what you'll be using. And you'll get these three off. That, and there's one up under the bottom there. Like I said, you can just pop these tabs out. You're going to take this one off with a Torx too. That's not the right Torx. So it must be, if it's not a T27, it must be like a T20 or a T25. But it's going to get that one out there. Pop that one straight out. You don't even have to unhook it or anything. Just pop it straight out. Yeah, so the one for this bolt right here is this. This is a T20 Torx. Exact same thing. T20 Torx. Get that off. Then we'll worry about the rest. Okay, so I already popped this out. So that one came out, and I just got it resting right here. This is all it is. So you just pop that out. You unscrew with that T20, pop that out. Just sit it right here to the side. This has that little alligator clip on it, like we said last time. So that just popped straight up and off. This was the sensor that was plugged into there. You know, separate that, separate the tab, press down, pop it straight out. This is just a screw off. So lefty, loosey, just left loose. You just keep turning it like that, left to the loose. And boop, pop it right out. Now it's in your hand. So now we pretty much got this in, taken apart. We just got to get these three bolts out here with the T27. Take those three out. We'll go down and work on that little clamp, the little clamp on the bottom, and it should pull straight out. Here you go. Probably one of the easiest things you're going to ever take off of this car. Trust me, super easy. Now, I took the whole clamp off. This is the whole clamp that was on there. Like I said, I pulled it up. You actually got to separate it by two pieces. This in here, you just kind of get it up. Once you pop it up, it slides out of the groove so it can come off the back, because it has to come off of that piece right there. It has to come off your turbo. Now, it sits on the front of your turbo. It just, it kind of like rests. That little clamp rests inside of the slot. So you have to get it up so it doesn't rest in that slot. So you can see, pull this piece apart. So once it's apart, like I said, I got the whole charge pipe off right here. Now I got to start working on getting this one on. Okay, after closer observation, you don't have to take these things off here. These stay with the old parts. The new one is just made out of aluminum. That's it. And you're gonna slip this clamp. The clamp I took off from here, just drop it in here. It fits right into these slots. It fits perfectly into these slots. Where you see like the little hole in the bottom, that's gonna aim straight to the bottom. This is gonna drop straight in from the top. You just snap it in place. The two little pieces on the side fit inside of those grooves. So once it gets locked onto that, you know, turbo down here, it's going to sit inside of that turbo perfectly. It's going to lock inside of those little silver grooves you see there, and that should hold it on. So yeah. And so now I want to start setting up my rubber boot and everything. So the first thing I'm going to do is, because this is going to be aiming towards me, this little locking nut, I'm going to aim this towards me instead of putting it up under the bottom. So I'm going to slide that on first and just let it kind of sit there. Then next, I'm going to put this big boot, slide it over here until this bevel right here sits inside of the groove on this. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the other side. I'm going to slide this, that clamp right there on top of that first. Slide this in place until it hits here. Lock everything in perfectly. And then I'm not going to tighten these up. I'm not going to tighten these up yet. I'm going to get everything positioned. Once everything's positioned, I'm going to tighten these when it's actually on the car. I might tighten that one first because that's the one that has to, you're going to be up under everything. But I could tighten this one last. The one at the top, I could tighten this one last just when I position everything. Okay, so now I got everything in place. I still haven't tightened this one down. I'm going to tighten the one on the bottom first. So I'm going to tighten that one down. I'm going to allow this one to still kind of turn so I can like go back and forth and angle it so I can get it to sit on my intake properly. But I'm going to tighten this down right now, start working it down to the car, snap that on, and then start working on this, getting it in position. And like I said, you got your sensor hole here at the top, and you also got your sensor hole there at the bottom, right there. That's the one you screw in and out right there. Okay, so you're going to use a 10 millimeter to tighten these down. So I use the 10, and you want to make it like even. You see how this is evenly from the edge of this, like this little bracket's easily. So you want to make sure your clamp is even all the way around so it's not kind of cocked sideways, because you want to give nice even pressure all the way around. So this thing is even all the way around, so it sits nice and flush with it. Because like sometimes you can have it cocked sideways like this where you see it'll have more exposed, and that's not sitting flush. So you want to make sure when you sit it, it's flush like that all the way around. It's nice and parallel with that hose clamp right there. Okay, so now I got the bottom part on there. As you can see, I got the bottom in there with my little retaining ring and everything. So what I did is, because of that little green O-ring on the inside, I put a little lube grease on it. Just like a little grease, not a whole lot. Just enough to get it to slip on, because it's real clean. All this stuff is brand new. So when I was trying to put it on there, I was kind of grabbing a little bit. So I took the ring, that little retaining ring, I took it completely off. Took it off, and I just put it on there after I got it on there all the way. But it's sitting down in the groove pretty securely, so it's not coming off. But inside there's like a little green ring. That little green ring on the inside of the new one. This has a little grease on it already because there's like oil and stuff in there. But you want to put like a little grease on that just to kind of get it nice so it slips onto that new piece. Because like I said, that turbo is going to be real nice and clean. And so that rubber is going to want to grab on there and not slide. But once you put that grease on there and you kind of just slide it, just kind of push it on there from the butt of it from back here. Kind of grab it, push it on there. It'll slide right on. Once it's on there, snap that retaining ring back in. It should be locked in there and good to go. So I even show you how nice, how secure it is. Let me see something. So as you can see, the pipe moves, but the ring doesn't. The ring's locked in there. So it's on there pretty good. It ain't going nowhere. And then I got my pieces here. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten this up. I'm going to rotate this around to about here. Well, I can probably do it about here. That's fine. Y'all can do it to about there. Whoops, do it to about there. Lock it on there. You know what? And then I've got, like I said, up here at the top, I've got my next two pieces I can get on there. And then those will slide right up in there like that. These will slide in, and I'll be all locked in and ready to go. Okay, so now I got my charge pipe locked onto my intake. Like I said, you want to make sure it's nice and secure around. I haven't hooked up anything else yet. I haven't tightened this yet because you want to make sure you get this out far enough. So, because you're going to have to adjust it. You're going to have to get it out to where you can adjust it and pull it up. So now it's locked in pretty good. It's locked in at the bottom, locked in here. I can tighten it up if I want to. But I'm going to go ahead and do my sensors and everything. Remember, don't forget your little sensor. You got to screw back in the bottom there. Make sure you got enough. Like I said, this is going to be kind of hard to do. So I might have to take it out of the harness. Because like I said, it's got not enough give to get it up under here. So, and I can't go through the bottom. So I got to do something. Probably take that out of the harness and running around here to drop it up under there. But you don't want to stretch those wires out too far, especially because they're so thin. So I'll probably pop it out of this harness here and run it up under there. It'll be fine. It'll be cool. But, you know, you can get this air box out the way, just sit it back here, kind of sitting on that knot right there. Now I can get down here, tighten that up, then I'll worry about my sensors in a second. Okay, got everything tightened down on that line that had to come across the top. I had to take it up under the bottom of the charge pipe. So this sensor goes up under the charge pipe instead of across the top of the old one. But like I said, everything's buttoned up, looks pretty good. I'm going to have to get this air box back on. Once I put the air box on, that's how it'll look. It'll sit in there like that, look pretty cool. I'll get a little after shot once I'm done. But yeah, that thing's locked in there. Like I said, everything is seamless. One of the easiest mods you're going to do. Only thing is, I was having a problem getting this over the top. I was like, wait a minute, let me go into the bottom because it's closer to that side. Went on the bottom, snap right in, no problem. Yep, it's in there pretty good. Yeah, but everything else, and then on the O-ring, on your top sensor here, just put a little bit of grease on it, snap right down in there, no problem. Like I said, because everything is so new, and those O-rings are real clean, you gotta kinda get a little grease on them, snap them down in there, they'll be okay. Okay, so there it all is, locked in, looks pretty good. That big old red thing sticking out in the middle kind of matches the car a little bit, making it look kind of smooth. Yeah, but I like that. Like I said, you can, I'm gonna see if I can see it down in here. No, you can't really see it down in there too much. Let me see if I can hit this light. Oh yeah, it's tucked down in there. You can see kind of like the base of it all the way down in there in the bottom. So it's tucked in there pretty good, you know, it's running up right up through there and everything. So I mean, there you go. One of the easiest mods you're going to do to this car. That's it. Now, let's see how it sounds. So that's it. Like I said, it's sitting in there pretty nice. I like the way that sounds. I still don't hear the blowout valve though, because usually I hear that a little bit. I don't hear it. I guess I'm gonna have to hear it as I'm driving. I don't know, I'll figure it out. But like I said, this thing is pretty nice. I love it, I love it. Man, this little car is the get up. This thing's a get up right here. Like I said, if you never had a BMW, trust me, start off with a 330, you're gonna love it, you're gonna love it.